In this example, we are given that a hydrogen atom is excited through electromagnetic radiation such that it emits visible light during de-excitation, and we are required to find the maximum wavelength of radiation by which it is possible. Now here you can see we are given that during de-excitation hydrogen is emitting visible light, which happens only when the de-excitation is corresponding to Balmer series. That means whenever from any higher orbit electron makes a transition to n equals to 2, we can write transition to n equals to 2 in hydrogen atom is corresponding to visible light or visible radiation. And initially, if we are given with hydrogen atom, it must be n equals to 1. So, any transition from higher orbit to n equals to 2, minimum energy must be required for exciting the hydrogen at least from 1 to 3, so that electron will make a transition from 3 to 2 and it will emit electromagnetic radiation. It is like this. Say, if it is n equals to 1, this n equals to 2, this n equals to 3. Initially, in hydrogen atom, we know that electron is in ground state, that is in n equals to 1. So, if it is excited to n equals to 3, and during de-excitation, if it makes a transition from n equals to 3 to 2, it will emit a visible light, which is corresponding to first line of Balmer series, which exist in visible radiation range. Now, in this situation, for excitation from 1 to 3, we need to supply an electromagnetic photon and save this photon 1. Then we can directly write energy of electromagnetic radiation required is this delta E. We can write for hydrogen, we can write as 13.6 multiplied by 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. It can be written as 1 by 1 square minus 1 by 3 square, which will be equals to 13.6 multiplied by this 1 minus 1 by 9, that is 8 by 9. On simplifying, we'll be getting is 12.09 electron volt. So, this much amount of energy of electromagnetic radiation is required to excite the hydrogen from 1 to 3. And for higher energies, again, it is possible because for any higher excitation, Balmer series radiation can be produced. So, here we can write wavelength corresponding to this energy is, which is the maximum wavelength of electromagnetic radiation corresponding to which energy is this. So, this lambda can be directly written as 12431 divided by 12.09, which will give us the value 1028 directly in angstrom. That will be the answer to this problem. So, any wavelength lower than this value will possess energy more than this, at which this is possible if the energy difference is equal to corresponding to transition levels which are involved in transition. So, maximum wavelength or minimum energy radiation which makes it possible is 1028 angstrom.